Hello.
Hi, Jim.
Hello, how are you doing?
Good.
Oh, good, yeah, yeah. Yeah, welcome.
Can you show us around a little bit, tell us a little bit about your way of sculpting?
Yeah, yeah, for sure, yeah. Basically, I mean, my way of sculpting is basically playing, you know, just, I've got a big pile of waste that I've collected over the years, you know, like things from the market, from eBay, from people who bought me, you know, things I've dismantled, you know, and I just get hold of it and I try it out, and sometimes, you know, I find a little face looking out at me and I make it into a little character or a little animal, or, you know, a dog or dancer or dragon or whatever comes. I never know what's going to come. I just start and ideas just evolve, you know.
How do you give your sculptures a soul?
Well, I usually find the soul is the first thing I see, really. I see the character looking out at me. It might just be, you know, two exhaust ports on an engine, and suddenly I see the eyes and the brow, and I think, oh, that looks like a dog or something. And then, you know, from that I'll also know roughly what sort of thing I'm looking for the dog. So then I look around for the dog's nose. But maybe then it might turn into something else. It might turn into a man, or it might be turned into a frog. I don't know. But it basically, I usually find the character first and then follow it, you know. So, you know, for example, in this one, I've made a bird here. And you know, he's all made of all sorts of things. He's even got a shotgun in there, you know, and a bicycle saddle. But it was the beak that started it. The beak and a pair of scissors broken in half made the eye, you know. And then I knew what sort of bird it was. I knew it was really primitive. It was like something out of the primordial swamps. So then I followed it through the old primitive bits of scrap, you know, rusty and decaying, you know. But this one, on the other hand, is completely different. You know, she's a dancer, she's graceful, and everything's done in chrome and shiny, gravy boats, bits of tap fittings, you know. So even though it's all scrap, you know, you have to make, you know, ways of scrap working together, you know, get an overall sort of integrity with the piece, you know, and tell the story.
What would you say were your biggest influences? Is it the classics or family or how?
Well,
I mean,
I was influenced, you know, by all the great artists I've known, including my father, Peter, and influenced by all the great artists that I've seen in museums, you know. Greatly influenced by the Natural History Museum and nature and the way that, you know, bones are constructed and animals are constructed and plants are constructed. And a great fascination with motorbikes. I learned my skill in the film studios in London, so I became a film scenic artist when I was young. So I learned my techniques, you know, how to use hundreds of different materials. And I've sort of jammed all those things into one pot and I've come up with my own style, you know, of storytelling.
And in terms of storytelling, you're really well known for your life in conservation, the Paralympics, Glastonbury, you know, Burning Man, Tea Party, which we all love. How would those stories differ from the stories that are told in your studio with your smaller sculptures, the intimate ones?
Well, yeah, you've got the right word, the intimate. You know, that the with these smaller ones, I think I can tell more of who they are, you know, what makes them function, where they are. I can tell a story like this wartime story between these two former adversaries who are now, you know, in this horrible mess they've created in the war, and looking at this one little flower growing out of it and just thinking about, what have they done? You know, what was that all about? So I can be able to tell a story there, which might be not so much in the rock and roll environment of festivals and events, you know. But otherwise, it's just the same stuff, but smaller, you know. Yeah.
And how do you feel when you? I know we're going to leave you soon. You've got a lot of work to do. But how do you feel when you're in your studio? When you're there.
I love it. I'm in a zone, you know. I'm in a zone. I know every piece of scrap in the place, every offcut, and I've got hundreds of things that are half made or just about to be made, or I've just seen them and wondering how they're going to go on, and that's just ticking over in my mind as I work away with my hands. And I'm very happy here. I never know in the morning what I'm going to produce that day at all, and then by the evening I'm going, oh look, I've made a bird, or oh look, I've made a dog, you know, just. it's a mystery to me what's going to come out, and that's why I like working this way, because it's very entertaining for me first of all.
Well, looking forward to seeing what you've got on there.
Oh, thank you very much. Yeah.
See you.
All right, bye.